As the moon positions itself perfectly between the Earth, it's going to cast that shadow all across the United States. Our WLWT News 5's Danielle Dindak, she spoke with a photographer who's done this before. He's traveled to go and watch these eclipses, and he's doing it again. Danielle, what did he have to say?
Yes, good morning, Stephen. Now, before I get to him, we have to talk about what's happening here at Markham Park. We're getting the party started early this morning because this afternoon there's going to be total darkness here for about a minute and a half and also a watch party. But like you said, I did have the chance to talk to a photographer who captured this eclipse back in 2017. And take a look at this. It's actually the cover of the observatory's calendar this year. So I had the chance to talk to him, and he explained the different phases that you'll see when you look up this afternoon.
It'll blow your mind when you see like the crescent. What you can see here is there's a gap between this the sun that's peeking out here. Now this is with the filter. This is filter on, filter removed. And do you see how there's a gap there? There's like a mist. That's called Bailey's beads. And the reason why there's a gap in the sun coming around there is because that's the peak of a crater on the moon, cutting off the sunlight. So that's always really awesome. Then this is another effect that they call, like to call the diamond ring. So it kind of looks like a diamond ring on the sun. So it's just different things. And then right before it goes full totality, you can see these red plasma ulcers, what they call prominences. And so I thought these were amazing because these are like the Earth could fit inside one of those. So like, it's just kind of like really crazy to see. These are stuff you can't see unless you've seen an eclipse. And when you start to see like how small and, you know, interesting it is. So these will come out in pictures that people have that are zooming in, you know, 300-400 millimeter lenses. That'll be neat. And then of course everyone will get to experience this. And when that happens, and all the time before this, even around here, you're looking at the temperatures dropping, you know, 10, 15 degrees.
Insane temperatures dropping 10 to 15 degrees. So that's one of his biggest advice that he's saying. If you're going out to watch this today, the forecast is looking nice, as Randy just mentioned, but he said to make sure you bring a jacket because, like he said, those temps are going to drop. He said another thing you should really think about is just making sure that you're aware of your surroundings. He says this is going to be such a great experience for everyone, but he said look around you. Take it all in, he said, from the animals to the insects to everything in between. Now, coming up in the next half hour, we'll talk a little bit more about what you need to grab before you head out the door. One of the biggest things, of course, are your glasses.